Andhra Pradesh on the defense of the removal ready.
The ready? India.
Japanese
emperor
to the metro, called on Governor K. Rotaya and Chief Minister Jayalalitha at the Rajbhavan today. Diana Kapoor has given a warm reception on the arrival at the Rajbhavan.
Never till that.
In return, the emperor and his consort visited the Gindi National Park. The visit to the park included an interaction with some school students. Last evening, the royal couple visited the Kalakshetra Foundation and were treated to an evening of classical music. In yet another engagement, the emperor and the empress went round the Sathya Society of Tamil Nadu amid children waving flags of both the countries. They also witnessed a session of yoga demonstration apart from interacting with the children.
இது ஜப்பான் நாட்டு அரசர் வந்திருக்காரு தமிழ்நாட்டுக்கு.
Shipping Minister G.K. Vasan has said the centre will not compromise with Sri Lankan government on the interests of Tamils in the island nation. Speaking to the media on the sidelines of an event at the Chennai Port Trust, the minister pointed out that India had voted against Sri Lanka during the UN resolution on human rights violations. He also recalled that Prime Minister Manmohan Singh did not attend the Chogam in Colombo in reflection of the sentiments of the Tamils. He said the centre was taking all steps to ensure the rights of the Tamils in the island nation, apart from taking efforts towards securing the implementation of the 13th Amendment and the permanent solution to the issue of Indian fishermen.
அதற்கு மாறாக இலங்கை அரசுக்கு அழுத்தம் கொடுத்து நம்முடைய அப்பாவி தமிழர்களுக்கு கிடைக்கக்கூடிய நியாயமான சிங்களர்களுக்கு கிடைக்கக்கூடிய உரிமையை நாம் பெற்றுத்தர வேண்டும். 13வது சட்டத்தை நீத்து போக அனுமதிக்க கூடாது. இவைகளெல்லாம் நம்முடைய மீனவர் பிரச்சனைக்கு விரைவில் ஏற்படும் ஒரு நல்ல முயற்சியை மத்திய அரசு மேற்கொண்டு வருகிறது. இவைகளெல்லாம் தொடர்ந்து வலியுறுத்தி மத்திய அரசு ஒரு நல்ல நிலை ஏற்படுத்துவதற்கு முயற்சி மேற்கொள்கிறது. தவிர இலங்கை அரசோடு சமரசம் என்ற நிலை என்றைக்குமே மத்திய அரசுக்கு கிடையாது.
Minister of State for Industries and Commerce Sudarshana Nadkepan has said Japanese experts were considering the possibility of an industrial corridor between Chennai and Bengaluru. Speaking to the media in the metro today, the minister said 1,500 Japanese experts were already in Chennai for the purpose. Detailing the project, the minister said the first leg would include Thiruvananthapuram, Tirunelveli, Virudhunagar, Sivagangai, Madurai, Pudukottai, Ramanathapuram, Kadalur and Virupuram. The second leg would pass through Coimbatore, Salem, Namakkal, Ranipetai, Krishnagiri, Kozhur, Bengaluru. He said lakhs of crores would be invested in the project, which would include Japanese financial assistance.
தொழில் பாதை என்று சொல்லப்படுகின்ற அந்த திட்டத்திற்காக நாங்கள் ஜப்பானுடைய அந்த நிபுணர்களை அழைத்து அவர்கள் முதலிலே ஒரு ஆய்வு செய்திருக்கிறார்கள். அதற்கு பின்னாலே இன்டர்நேஷனல் சென்டர் மூலமாக 1,500 அறிஞர்கள் இங்கே வந்திருக்கிறார்கள். அவர்கள் தமிழகம் முழுவதும் சுற்றுப்பயணம் செய்து அந்த இண்டஸ்ட்ரியல் காரிடார் என்ற திட்டத்தினை ஆய்வு செய்வதற்காக வந்திருக்கிறார்கள். அது பல லட்சக்கணக்கான கோடி ரூபாய் அது செலவு செய்யப்பட இருக்கிறது.
ஒய்எஸ்ஆர் Congress Chief Jagan Mohan Reddy called on DMK Chief Karunanithi as part of the ongoing lobbying exercise in reiteration of an united Andhra Pradesh. According to sources, Jagan Mohan Reddy had sought the support of Karunanithi for a united state of Andhra. Later speaking to the media, Jagan Reddy said he had been seeking the support of the senior leaders on an amendment to the third clause of the constitution which dealt with the bifurcation of states. She said the amendment was necessary as in case Andhra Pradesh is bifurcated today, the same would happen to other states in the future.
I want everybody who supports democracy with me. I want all the floor leaders to come and support this issue. Because if this issue is people keep quiet, Andhra Pradesh would be the precedent. Andhra Pradesh would be the first state to be divided without an assembly resolution in place. And this is not going to be healthy.
She said his party would be majority of MP seats in Andhra Pradesh and will play a crucial role in the formation of the next government at the centre. It may be recalled that Jagan Reddy called on AIADMK Supremo and Chief Minister Jayalalithaa yesterday in Chennai as well. In a record-breaking poll statistics, the Erkad Assembly by poll held yesterday registered 90% voter turnout. This reserved constituency had recorded about 85% turnout in the 2007 Assembly elections. With adequate central forces deployed along with the local police contingent, the polling went off peacefully. The proactive measures of the election commission seem to have had its impact in the election. Apart from voter slips, SMSs had also been sent to all voters whose mobile numbers were listed in the electoral database, giving the serial numbers of their ID card. The by-election witnessed a straight contest between the ruling AIADMK and the opposition DMK with a total number of 11 candidates in the fray. Interestingly, the Congress, which had been a part of the DMK-led UPA and DMDK, which was an ally of the ruling AIADMK, in the last election stayed away from the polls. Allegations of distributing cash and gifts to entice the voters hogged the limelight during the campaign, with special teams of the Election Commission seizing over 3 crores of cash and gift items meant for distribution. Counting will be taken up on Sunday, the result of which will be crucial for the two main Dravidian parties in the run-up to the Lok Sabha elections. Chennai Wet offers a forecast rain in most places along coastal Tamil Nadu with the heavy showers in a few places. According to the director of the Met Office, S.R. Ramanan, the low-pressure trough is persisting in southwest Bay of Bengal. Fishermen have been advised to be cautious as the trough seems to be moving towards the north.
தென்மேற்கு வங்கக்கடல் நிலை விவரம்.